Hello, it's Keith here, and this is the first of my Hello World series. In this series, we're going to create a simple single ASM file for each platform that will show the Hello World message onto the screen. Now, once we get the Hello World onto the screen, we're going to extend that with some code from my regular series that shows them what's known as the monitor. This is the registers of the system and also banks of memory. The idea is if you're starting out with one of these systems and you want to do things yourself, you're going to need a little bit of stuff to get you started, you know, just to be able to access the video hardware and see what the registers are doing, or just to check that your program's even loading into memory properly. And being able to see the contents of the register and bits of the memory, it's really going to help with that. But of course, we're going to need to know how to actually get your program running as well. And to do that, we're going to look at how to build the file, make a disk or cartridge as required for each system, and that's what we do. Now, in this one, we're going to be looking at the BBC, and we're going to learn how to make a Hello World example for the BBC. Okay, let's go over to the code and see that in action then. Okay, so this is the code we're going to be running today. So straight away, let's just see it running in action then. So here we go. You can see we're in BBC Basic here, and we're showing a Hello World message here. Now, in my previous tutorial, we looked at doing some graphics modes, and we used a graphics mode to show Hello World. But if our pure task is just to get Hello World onto the screen, that's not the way we want to do things. What we want to do is use the most simple way, which is the text mode. So that's what we've done here. So you can see we've shown Hello World, and we've returned back to Basic. Well, how have we done that? Well, the code is really quite straightforward because the firmware is able to do the jobs for us. We've just got a command called printchar here, and that will print a single character to the screen. And we've got a new line command, which will obviously start a new line. Pretty straightforward. Now, when it comes to showing a string to the screen, to maintain compatibility across all of my tutorials, I use my own print string routine. You can see it just here. So my procedure for programming for a new system is to get a character to the screen and then extend that into a print string and then later on into the monitor program, as I mentioned before. So my print string routine is just here. And what we do, now when we want to get a character to the screen, all we do is we call address FFE3 here, and that will take the accumulator and it will show it to the screen, and it works in ASCII. It's perfect for what we need. Now, when it comes to the string, I use two zero page entries. I'm using zero page 20 and 21 for the high and low parts of the address, the 16-bit address. And then I read in a byte from that address using Y as a counter here, reading in until I get to a character 255, which is my end of line marker. I use 255 because that's what the original Chibi Akuma's game used. I know a lot of stuff uses zero, but that's not the way I've come to do things. And we just keep running the print char routine for each character until we get to the end of the line. Now, after we've printed our Hello World message, we start a new line because Basic would otherwise continue on the same line. So just for clarity, we do that. So we saw that. Let's just see it again. And there you go. You can see you've got this Hello World message here. Very straightforward. Now, of course, the code is very straightforward in this example. But apart from the org 3000 here, which is the start of the code, there's nothing really here to actually do any more work. So the real challenge of starting programming a new system is working out how to actually build whatever disk tape images are required for the system. And I use a batch file here. You may have seen when I pressed F6 here. You can see I've got this option here, VASM BBC, and there is a script here. Now we'll just have a look at that right now. So I use these batch files. And you can see there's some code up here and down here, but honestly, you can ignore quite a bit of this because some of it's just my testing code. So the important bit is this line here. This is the VASM assembler. We're using the old style version, 6502, of course, and we're specifying some parameters here. Now we've got the build file, which is the ASM file we want to compile. We're setting it to check labels. Now this is quite a handy thing. Check labels is something where the assembler will check if any of our labels look like commands. Now the reason they would look like commands is because we've forgotten to put a tab. If we put a return command at the far left, it's going to look like a label, and that will warn us, and it'll save you a lot of time, I find. I disable case sensitivity. I don't use case sensitive code, so that's what I do for the ease. I've got a symbol being defined as VASM equals 1. This is, in some cases, I've had to use multiple assemblers, and so I sometimes switch different parts of the code depending on what assembler I'm using. It's not needed in this case, though. I'm defining a symbol BBC here. This will be needed by the monitor code, but the Hello World example you just saw won't need this. What we do need though is to tell it we're outputting a binary file. You see this F bin here, that will tell it we're outputting binary, and slash O specifies the output file, and I'm calling it $.boot, and the boot B has got a capital there. Now that file name is kind of important because that's going to be copied to our disk in just a moment. And then finally, you can see there's this listing being output just here, and this is for debugging. You won't need it if your code's working fine, but if things are really going wrong, you can look at that and see how each command compiled to bytecode. You can check the labels. Sometimes you'll find out that you're having some kind of problem. Maybe the code's not working your way you thought. It's not impossible that you might find there's a bug in the assembler or that the assembler is malfunctioning with a trick you're trying to use. You know, if you're using different symbols and different calculations of addresses, sometimes the assembler will get confused by what you're doing. So it's worth doing, but it's not something you need as such. So that's our first assemble here. That will create a file from our source code. If there's an error, we just give up. But now what we want to do is we want to create a disk. So what we're doing here is we're creating a disk and we're adding the boot file that we created to a disk here. And we're using this program called bbcinf, which will be for creating images, disk images for the BBC. And that's what I use in my tutorials. Of course, all of my tutorial samples you can download from my website. You're welcome to do so. And hopefully all this will be set up and working for you. So that's something you can do. But if you want to create your own script, then this is how you do it. So we're loading that file into the disk image here. And then what we're doing is we're telling it to make the disk bootable and that the boot mode is run. Now, there's multiple options for how you actually start the disk. So we're setting it to run mode. And then at this point, our disk is ready. We just copy it into our destination, the release BBC folder. And we start bbm with that disk image, and that will start as we just saw. So that was the basic Hello World version. Now, as I say, we can extend that. What I'm doing now is I'm including some extra tools. You can see there's some extra bits of code here. I'm not going to go into them because they're too complicated. But basically, I'm including a monitor function that I wrote before. This provides us with a few new options. A monitor command, which will show the state of the registers of the system. Good if your program is malfunctioning, maybe your loops are going over what you thought they would. Well, maybe you want to see the values of those loop counters. And a memdump, which is great if you think that something's going wrong. You can double check your memory's not getting corrupted. You can check where your program's being loaded into memory. If you've got bits of memory you're using for temporary variables, you can view those. You could even view the zero page. So that memdump command will take an address and it will take a number of lines and it will show them to the screen, as we'll see in just a moment. So let's fire that up. So here we go. So you can see we've got our hello message, world messages before. So you can see we've got some registers here. We've got the accumulator, X and Y, the stack, the flags, and also the program counter here. So this is the current running address. And then we've dumped memory address 3000. And you can see we've got three lines here in both hexadecimal and in ASCII here where possible. So as I say, this is really intended to be able to help you out if you're just getting started, but you want to do things yourself. Once you can get some kind of response to the screen and be able to work dynamically with the system, you know, changing something and then reading it back and then showing the result to the screen, that's usually enough to make some really significant progress. I usually find once I can get Hello World working, things really start to escalate. It can sometimes take me a week to figure out how to make Hello World work just because I don't understand anything about the hardware and I don't have any way of outputting what's going on to the screen. Or also because sometimes I can't even get anything to compile and run because I don't know how to make a disk image. So, as I say, this is hopefully just giving you enough to get started and then you can take things your own direction. But of course, if you want more help, my tutorials cover all kinds of other things on the BBC. So that's the other way you can do things. Okay, so that's what I wanted to cover for the BBC. As I say, there's more content on the BBC and we're going to be going forward on this simple series, as it's going to be called in the future. And we're going to look at how to do simple bitmaps and simple keyboard or joystick reading as required for the system. So we're going to do a few more lessons of this very basic way of doing things. All the examples you see today are available for download on my website, as are the tools. So please go ahead and do so. I really appreciate you watching today. If you've enjoyed this lesson, please like and subscribe because it really helps with the motivation of working on these tutorials. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed programming today. Thanks for watching and goodbye.